This video was made possible by Wix. If you're ready to create a website, head on over to wix.com/go/infographics2019 to try out one of their premium plans right now. There must have been a day when a person belonging to an ancient civilization got a hold of a piece of gold and thought, huh, I kinda like this. Since then, it's become a metal that denotes wealth, a powerful symbol that wraps around our fingers, and for some people, covers their teeth. How did it happen? There's evidence that gold impressed humans as far back as 40,000 BC. The ancient Egyptians loved the stuff, and it's said pharaohs couldn't get enough of it. They even used it as currency, with the deal being that one piece of gold was worth as much as two pieces of equal weight silver. How come silver got the raw deal? Why did the ancient Greeks hold this kind of bling in high esteem, making it the status symbol it still is today? Let's investigate. So we already know that some of the ancients prized this stuff. We also know that in the Bible there's mention of heavenly lands covered with gold. We know other civilizations from the Aztecs to the Persians cherished it. It wasn't that hard to find either, and all over the world someone could just acquire gold. Why is it expensive though? You might be thinking, well, it's gold, man. It's just expensive because it is. But not all things mankind cherishes are very expensive. Maybe you have a thing for marble, and that's relatively cheap. Okay, so the first reason is a matter of geology. While gold can be found all over the place, it is still rare, rarer than, say, oak wood. So to get gold, you have to mine, and mining is labor-intensive. You then have to clean up the gold and make it look nice, and that also takes hard work. That's one of the reasons gold is expensive, but it doesn't explain everything. You see, some metals that are very abundant are obviously cheap, but there are other metals that are just as rare as gold that are also cheap. One example is the metal called ruthenium. We just looked online to see the price and we're told it's now going for $9,000 per kilogram. We're also told that if we buy a kilo of gold today, we'll have to pay $41,149. That just doesn't seem right. In the list of the rarest metals in the world, one metallurgy website tells us that gold is the 7th and ruthenium is 6th. The second rarest of them all, though, rhodium, is very expensive. You can get a kilo of that stuff today for $91,308. The 8th rarest metal, platinum, has been expensive in the past, but now you can get your hands on a kilo for just $26,106. What you can see here is that rarity does make something expensive, but it doesn't define the price overall. Otherwise, platinum would cost more than gold, and poor ruthenium wouldn't be a bargain basement metal. Now for a bit of science, there's a reason gold is rare. That's because it's a heavy atom, consisting of 79 protons and 118 neutrons. Now, back before we had science and the ancients had no idea where gold came from, the Egyptians called it the breath of God, and the Aztecs called it the sweat of the sun. While this sounds kinda pretty, the sun didn't sweat gold out and God didn't come onto planet Earth. What actually happened was a great big supernova in space forged gold atoms and hurled them across the universe. As the story goes, billions of years ago, meteorites packed with gold hit the Earth. Little did they know that one day they'd end up covering Flava Flav's teeth. As for that first gold, it sank when molten iron was busy making the core of the Earth. Now, we said it's rare, but it's not super rare. Say, it's not as rare as a five-legged horse. Yes, they exist. We don't know exactly how much gold there is because we haven't dug it all up. But the World Gold Council said that as of 2019, the entire amount of gold that has been mined is 190,040 metric tons. That equals about 418,878,298 pounds of gold, or 190 million kilos of it. Let's just make a quick calculation in our head. 190 million times 41 and a bit equals about $7 trillion. No doubt if you had all the world's gold, you can get an invite to Jeff Bezos's country club. Okay, so it's rare, but not that rare. There's enough of it to build a skyscraper. It is expensive because it takes a lot of work to mine it. But that's not all. It's also a really handy metal to work with. It's corrosion resistant and it can be made into nice shapes that people can admire. Some metals are very hard to smelt, but gold isn't. So you have a very pretty metal that doesn't corrode and you can easily make things out of it. Silver is also kinda rare and also has a relatively low melting point. But there is a problem with silver, and that's the fact that it tarnishes. Gold hits all the spots. It really is the perfect kind of metal. It remains perfect too, for a long time. As the BBC put it, gold's relative inertness means you can create an elaborate golden jaguar and be confident that in 1,000 years it can be found in a museum display case in central London, still in pristine condition. If you have gold, you're holding good currency. The value remains quite stable, which makes it something people want to have. The value has dropped before, of course, but nothing as major as the drop in the 16th century when vast amounts of the stuff was discovered in South America. Back then, people used to talk about cities of gold, but they were never found. Still, if you look at gold prices from the low in 2001 to the high in 2011, there's a massive difference. What we are trying to say is that it always has been expensive, but it has been cheaper. So to recap again, gold is rare, rare means expensive. Gold also has a history of being admired, which does add to the cost. Today, it's still seen as something that denotes high status, and like Gucci bags, that keeps the price high. Not only that, it keeps its shape and it doesn't corrode. It's nice on the eye and you can easily make cool stuff out of it. That's about it, really. But not everything that looks good needs to cost a fortune. Like, for example, a great-looking website. If you're ready to build your personal website about gold, other precious metals, or anything at all, they can help you get it up and running in seconds by using one of their fully customizable templates. Or you can use their powerful design tools to design something exclusively yours. Their subscription services offer 24/7 tech support, and they have an incredibly robust knowledge base, which we describe as being more valuable than gold when building a website. So try out Wix today by visiting the link in the description or going to wix.com/go/infographics2019. Can you think of something else? Tell us in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other video, What if the United States paid off its debt? Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.